Hello everyone, I am Shivantika, legal intern at Lexis & Company, and today in this video we'll understand what are negotiable instruments, what does one mean by negotiation, what are the different modes of transfer of a negotiable instrument, and thirdly we'll point out the difference between assignability and negotiation. So let's get started with the video. So first of all, a negotiation of an instrument should be distinguished from transfer by assignment. This is one important concept altogether. So when a person transfers his rights to receive the payment of a debt, that is called as an assignment of the debt. For example, when the holder of a life insurance policy transfers the right to receive the payment to another person, it is nothing but an assignment. Similarly, when a holder of a bill of exchange, note or check, transfer the same to another in a sense of giving him the right to receive the payment of the instrument to that transferee. In this also, the negotiation and the assignment, the element of transfer of the rights of the right of receipt of payment of debt is involved even in these situations. So the right which the transferee of the instrument by negotiation acquires in such a situation are substantially superior to those of an assignee. So there is a difference between the two when we call it as the assignee, or when we are transferring it to another person, like for the whole process itself. So an instrument that is payable to the bearer can be negotiated by simple delivery. The person to whom the instrument is to be delivered becomes the holder of the same. For example, if I assign you or simply deliver to you a check tomorrow, then the person like you whom the delivery is to be made, you become the holder in such a situation. Though delivery in simple is an important formality, for without it, no possessor is constituted as a holder of the instrument itself. A person who steals or, for example, finds a bearer instrument, he or she will not be accepted as the holder of the same, as it has not been delivered to him. Although if he delivers the same to another person, that person becomes a holder. For example, if you find a check, suppose you find a check on the road, fallen on the road, and you pick it up, and you don't become the holder of the check itself. Okay, but when you assign that check to another person who has no knowledge that you have acquired the check in such a manner, that person becomes the holder of that check. Okay, so subject to the provisions of section 58, a promissory note, a bill of exchange, or a check payable to bearer is negotiable by delivery. Okay, so it is to be noted here that a promissory note or a bill of exchange or a check delivered on condition, that is to take effect except in certain event, it is not negotiable except in the hands of the holder for value without notice of the condition, unless such event happens. So what is it? That it is to be noted that the promissory note, the bill of exchange, or the check delivered on condition that it is to take effect except in certain event, it is not negotiable unless such event happens. So this is called as the negotiation by delivery. Okay, now an instrument is payable to order is negotiated by the instrument, by the endorsement and the delivery. Thus, endorsement requires two conditions, or we can call two things. That is, one, the holder should endorse it, and then it should be delivered to the endorsee. So the conditions are: the holder should endorse the same check or the bill of exchange that we are talking about, and the another is it must be delivered to the endorsee itself. So there is a different we understand that there is a difference between negotiation and assignability, as the negotiation of an instrument should be distinguished from the transfer by assignment. When a person transfers his right to receive the payment of the debt, it is called as assignment of the debt. Where, for example, suppose the holder of a lifetime insurance policy transfers the right to receive the payment to another person, let's say. That is just an example of an assignment. It is not negotiation. It is just assignment. Okay. Now, suppose when a holder of bill of exchange or a note or a check transfers the same to another, he in essence gives the right to receive the payment of the instrument to the transferee. Thus, both negotiation as well as assignment, that is transfer of the right to receive the payment of a debt. But the similarity ends there itself. For the right which the transferee of an instrument by negotiation acquires are substantially superior to that of an assignee. So there is a difference between the two concepts. I hope you understand this same through this video. Thank you so much.